Hey guys, welcome back to San Diego. I'm Justin Tyler from Newsarama.com here talking to Marc Guggenheim. Thank you for joining me, man.
No, thank you. Thanks for having me.
So this is a big sort of coming home con for you. It's been a while since you've done some comics work, and you're looking to jump back in?
I am. It's funny. It's been a while since I was even at Comic-Con. I took last year off, and I haven't written a regular DC or Marvel comic for a couple of years now. I got busy with television and with movies, and
boo, boring.
I know. It's very attractive and alluring. And I'm still doing that stuff, but I've managed to carve out some time for comics, and I want to get back into it because I'm just jonesing for it. I miss it.
So what's that like to come back here? Do you have to sort of be like, remember me? And just be like, hey, put your comic book flag up for everybody to see? We're back. We've been moved. This is our fourth location for the interview. We're really trying to get a real topography, trying to get your face out there
as much as popular. We're now.
Exactly. We want to be fresh.
Excellent.
So we were talking about sort of reintroducing yourself to
yes.
the comic book world.
Yes. You know, a lot of it's, just reestablishing old relationships and, reconnecting with editors I haven't spoken with in a while and saying, hey, I'm available, I'm free, and, here's what I'm thinking, what are you thinking? And that's the fun stuff. And one of the things actually I miss about comics is I miss the people, I really, all the relationships I've made with writers, other writers and other editors and artists, we have a lot of really great people in this industry, and I just, it's like coming home.
It's a friendly community, and it must make it a lot easier for you to be like, hey, what's going on, guys? I want to do blank. I want to do question mark.
It's funny. I'm very much I never go, hey, I want to do this, or is this book available? The one thing I've said is I would love to do one book, not juggle a bunch of different things, do one book, do it really great. I feel like I've learned a lot just as a writer working in movies these last 2 years. It's that's great boot camp for writing.
Yeah, yeah.
And I just want to apply some of those new skills to one specific book and, preferably a book that's not my last book, like I said, was JSA, which was huge and sweeping with a gajillion characters.
Right.
I like to be a few characters short of gajillion this time.
Yeah. Nice. So speaking of this Hollywood place you're talking about, what have you been working on? Arrow, I know for sure.
It's funny. There's a lot of movie stuff I can't talk about, but I'll tell you. I'm working on Arrow, which is this TV show based on the Green Arrow comic. And we're coming out in October on the CW, October 10, 8 p.m.
Prime time,
yes. Check it on out. And it's fun. It's gotten a terrific response here. We've screened it twice, and it's just been a magical project for us.
Why Green Arrow? I know you probably weren't involved in the development too much, but what is it about archery that seems to be seizing the world stage between Hunger Games and all these different archery-based heroes?
It's
why
crazy.
Green Arrow?
You know what? Honestly, I don't know. And the funny thing is, the thing I've been telling people is, I don't think the people behind Brave knew about Hunger Games. I don't think people behind Hunger Games knew about the Avengers. There's something that happens every couple of years in the pop culture. The zeitgeist hits, and it is just undeniable.
Yeah.
So it was weird, but a year ago was when we started developing Green Arrow, and it all started with Peter Roth, who's the head of Warner Brothers Television. He really, really wanted a Green Arrow TV show.
Really? Wow.
Yeah, he was hardcore about it and very passionate, and came to me and Greg Berlanti and was like, you guys have to do this. You have to do this. And we're like, oh, we're really busy. We don't know. And we started thinking about it. And once you start thinking about Green Arrow, it is really hard to say no. We just started kicking around these ideas that super excited us. And we were, just jazzed.
For everybody at home who hasn't seen it, give us sort of the take on it. How's it a little different from the comics? And what do you bring into the TV?
Well, if you're familiar with the comics, it's very sort of tonally, it's very similar to Longbow Hunters and Green Arrow Year One by Andy Diggle and Jock. And it's, it's very dark, it's very grounded, it's realistic. Honestly, it is the Chris Nolan version of Green Arrow.
Wow.
I mean,
that's a great pull quote right there for you guys.
I make no bones about it. We're going for Dark Knight, the TV show. We draw a lot of inspiration from that hyper-realistic, very grounded approach because it works with a vigilante. We always say it's not a superhero show, it's a crime thriller. And this guy is a hero, he's a man, and he's just been through hell on this island, and he's come back, and he's going to redeem himself for all the bad stuff that he's done.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And so what other stuff are you working on the Hollywood side of things? I did what's called research a little bit, and yeah, very exciting. I saw The Flash popped up on your IMDb page. I just wanted to check in about that.
Yeah, Greg Berlanti, Michael Green, and I, we had written the Green Lantern movie, at least, you know, the original screenplay for it. And then Warner Brothers hired us to do the same thing with The Flash. And we turned in our draft. We did a rewrite for them, which is typical, you know, studio procedure. And we're just waiting to see what happens. I think, you know, the latest news seems to be wait for Justice League and then, you know, launch spin-off movies out of that. At least that's what seems to have been the most recent announcement. So we'll see. In the meantime, I've been continuing to work at Warner Brothers. I'm writing Perry Mason for them and Robert Downey Jr. right now. And then there's another movie I've been working on that wraps production next week. But I can't talk about it because my involvement's not public yet.
Oh, wow. So it's a...
That's a project that I've been working on for, like, going on 2 years now. And it's, you know, it's, again, it's one of the reasons why I haven't been able to take on too much comic book work. But it's wrapping next week, so we're really excited about it. I can't wait to talk about it because I've seen footage and it's awesome.
Oh, that's great. That's really exciting. Well, good luck to you in the comic book side of things. We'd love to have you back in the fold. And you guys, stay tuned to play more from Comic-Con.